बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम। आई एम तैयब, आई एम योर फिजिक्स टीचर। टुडे आवर कंटेंट इज न्यूमेरिकल ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 3। प्रॉब्लम नंबर 1, द स्टेटमेंट ऑफ आवर न्यूमेरिकल 3.1 इज द फोर्स ऑफ 20 मीटर मूव अ बॉडी विद एन एक्सेलरेशन ऑफ 2 मीटर पर सेकंड। वी हैव अ फोर्स ऑफ 20 न्यूटन, acceleration is 2 meter per second, and what is its mass required in mass? The formula F is equal to ma, putting the value of the formula F is equal to ma that is given of Newton's second law of motion, F is equal to ma. The value of F is 20, we want to find m, and the value of acceleration is 2 meter per second square. 2 multiply by m and divide on the other side. And we simplify the value, and the value of mass is 10 kg. Next statement is the weight of the body is 147 newton. Weight is equal to F is equal to 147 newton. The value of g is, you already know that the value of g is 10 meter per second square. What is its mass? We want to find mass. The formula, you already know that according to the second law of motion, F is equal to ma. You know that F is equal to W is equal to mg. First of all, we will find the m. First of all, we will find the m because we don't have a mass. W is equal to mg, g multiplied and divide on the other side. The value of W is 147 and value of g is 10. 147 divided by 10, we have answer 14.7 kg. Then and the mass is 14.7. This is the answer. The statement of numerical 3.3. How much force is needed to prevent a body of mass 10 kg? How much force? We want to find force. And the mass 10 kg. M is equal to 10 kg. Then the value of G is 10. You already know that the value of G is 10. We already know about the formula F is equal to W is equal to mg. By putting the value F is equal to W is equal to mg. The value of m is 10, the value of g is 10. Multiply 10 and 10. The answer is 100 newton, F is equal to 100 newton. This is the answer of third numerical. Numerical number 4, the statement of numerical number 4 is find the acceleration produced by a force of 100 newton in a mass of 50 kg. Find the acceleration. We want to find acceleration. We have a force is 100 newton and mass is 50 kg. Mass is a 50 kg. Again, according to Newton's second law of motion, F is equal to ma. M is multiplied by a, divide on other side. F divided by m is equal to a. By putting this value, we have F 100 newton and the mass is 50 kg. 100 divided by 50 kg, and then acceleration is equal to 2 meter per second square. This is the answer of fourth numerical. Numerical number 5th. The statement of fourth numerical is a body has weight 20 newton. W is equal to 20 newton. How much force is required? We want to find force to move it vertically upward. The bodies move vertically upward. Then you know that the value of G is negative because the body is going vertically upward with an acceleration of 2 meter per second square. And we have acceleration of 2 meter per second square. Again, we know that about the formula W is equal to mg. By putting the value of W is 20 and the g is 10. G multiply by m and divide on the other side, and m is equal to 2 kg. And now we have to find F2, you know that F is equal to ma. The value of m is 2 kg that we have already found. And the value of A is 2 meter per second square. 2 multiply by 2, then the answer is 4. F2 is equal to 4. Then we add F1 and F2. 20 newton and 4 newton. The answer is 24 newton. This is the net force. Then the other numerical is 3.6. The statement of 3.6 is two masses, 52 kg and 48 kg. And that means M1 is equal to 52 kg and M2 is equal to 48 kg. attached to the end of the string that possesses a frictionless pulley. Find the tension in the string. First of all, we will find the tension and the acceleration in the bodies, and second one is acceleration. When the both mass are moving vertically. Both masses are moving vertically. And page number 65. The given the formula of tension. T is equal to 2m1 m2 over m1 plus m2 g. This formula is given on your physics textbook page 65. You have a given m1 and m2 and m1 m2. Putting the value m1 m2 and the value of g, then simplify. Then we can simplify. Then the value of tension is 500 newton. Then t is equal to 500 newton. Now we find second one is acceleration. Now we want to find acceleration. The value and the formula of acceleration is same as on your physics textbook, page number 65. A is equal to m1 minus m2 divided by m1 plus m2 over g. Putting the value m1 m2, and then we simplify the then answer of acceleration is 0.4 meter per second square. This is a numerical of 3.6. The next numerical 3.7. The statement of 3.7 is two masses, 26 kg and 24 kg, are attached to the end of the string. M1 is equal to 24 kg, M2 is equal to 26 kg, which possesses over a frictionless pulley. 26 kg is lying over a smooth horizontal table. 24 kg mass is moving vertically downward. Find the tension in the string. First of all, we will find the tension and the acceleration in the body. Second one, we want to find acceleration. Same that as the numerical 3.6. The formula T is equal to M1 M2 over M1 plus M2 G. This formula is given on your physics textbook, page number 67. Because in this numerical, the statement is saying that the one mass is horizontal and one mass is lying on the table. That's why the formula of acceleration and tension is present on your physics textbook, page number 67. Putting the value m1 and m2, and then we simplify, the answer of tension is 125 newton. Then second one is we want to find acceleration. The formula of acceleration is m1 over m1 plus m2 g. The value, you already know that the value of m1 m2 that is given on your given data, the value of g is 10. Then acceleration is equal to 4.8 meter per second after to simplify. This is the numerical of 3.7. Next numerical is 3.8. The statement of numerical 3.8 is, how much time is required to change 22 newton momentum. Change in momentum, it's mean del p is equal to 22 newton second by the force of 20 newton. F, we have a f and we have a del p, then we want to find t. The formula f is equal to del p over t. The text, this formula is given on your textbook, page number 68. This formula is given on your physics textbook, page number 68. F is equal to del P over T. The value of F is 20 newton given on your data, and the value of del P is 22 newton. P multiply by 20 and 20 divide on the other side. Then we can simplify. Then the value of T is 1.1 second. This is the answer of 3.8 numerical. And the numerical of 3.9. How much is the force of friction? We want to find force of friction in this numerical. Between the wooden block of mass, we have a mass of 5 kg and the horizontal marble floor. The coefficient of friction between the wood and the marble is 0.6. Coefficient of friction is a mu. Mu is 0.6. 0.6. Then the mu has no no unit. That's why mu s is equal to 0.6 newton. The formula F is equal to mu mg. This formula is given on your physics textbook, page number 73. This formula is given on your physics textbooks, page number 73. The value of mu is 0.6 and the value of m is 5 kg and value of g is 10. That's then F is equal to 30 newton. This is the answer of 3.9 numerical. Last numerical, the statement of numerical is how much centripetal force? We want to find centripetal force. FC mean centripetal force. FC means centripetal force is needed to make a body of mass 0.5 kg. We have a mass of 0.5 kg to move a circle of radius. Radius R is equal to 0.5 kg and R is equal to 3 meter per second square. R is equal to 50 centimeter. Then we will convert centimeter into meter, divide by 100. Then we have answer 0.5 meter. And the value of V last may with a speed 3 meter per second. The value of V 3 meter per second. We have a formula FC is equal to MV square over R. This is a formula of centripetal force. Centripetal force. The formula of centripetal force is given on your textbook page number 78. FC is equal to MV square over R. We have a value of M 0.5 and the value of V is 3 meter per second square and the value of R is 0.5. Then we will simplify and the answer is 9 kilogram per meter second square. And FC is equal to 9 newton because you know that the unit of force is newton. Thank you.